It's actually quite a high proportion of patients. I would say at least half, if not more. The average age of a patient with AML is in their upper 60s, and these patients are probably not captured in many of our clinical trials because they're not eligible for certain reasons. So I think one important thing we can do going forward is figure out how to apply some of these novel regimens to more frail, more elderly patients that just simply weren't eligible for those clinical trials. And so that'll be sort of an exciting real-world application of some of the clinical trials going forward.